Hi, this is Suzanne for Rainbow Loom. Today I'll be showing you how to make the Speckled Rhombus Bracelet. This is a beginner level design. To make this bracelet you will need 18A colored bands, 16B colored bands, 8C colored bands, and a C-clip. It's a good idea to have your supplies ready before you begin, so pause the video here until you're ready to follow along. Now, let's get started. Place your loom so that the red arrow is pointing away from you. Start by placing the first 10 bands on the loom. Follow the diagram on your screen as we place these bands. We'll start from the center pin and place 1A. Then we'll place 2A from the middle pin forward. 3B, push those down. 4C goes across. Then 5B goes back. Then 6A. Seven A, eight B, nine C, and 10B. It's very important that you follow this exact order as we show you. We'll do this one more time. 1A, 2A, 3B, 4C, 5B, 6A, 7A, 8B, 9C, and 10B. Pause the video here and refer to the diagram until you reach the end of the loom. We'll fast forward from here. That last band to the center pin. Now we'll need to place a cap band on this pin. So grab an A colored band, place two fingers through each side, twist it into a figure eight, turn it back upon itself, and place it on that last pin. Now we're ready to start looping the bands. Turn the loom so that the red arrow is pointing toward you. Refer to the graphic on your screen as you loop the first 10 bands. We start from the center pin. Pull the cap band back with your hook. Grab the top B band and loop it forward. Then you go back to that same pin, pull back the cap band, grab the second B band, and that one gets looped out to the right. Then we'll loop 3C, pull back your band till you find that C band, and then loop that to the center pin. Then you're going to loop 4A. You pull all those bands back, find that A band, and loop it out to the side. 5A will be looped forward. Six B, 7C, eight B, nine A, and 10A. We'll follow this pattern one more time. 1B, pull the bands back, and that will be the first B band on the top if you kept them in the right order as you place them, and loop that. Then 2B will be pulled out to the side, and you pull that out. Notice how each one of those forms this teardrop shape. That shows you that you pulled and looped the bands correctly. 3C, 4A, 5A. Six B, seven C, eight B, nine A, and 10A. Pause the video here and refer to the diagram on your screen until you finish looping all of the bands. And we pull this last band into the center, and we've completed looping all of our bands. Now that we've finished looping the bands, we're ready to finish the bracelet. Pull all the bands on this last pin up to the top. Slide your hook through the channel of that last pin and tilt it out to the side. Place an A-colored band on the end of your hook. Pull back and slide that up through the channel and place both bands up on your hook and then slide them to the thickest part. Then with your fingers, you grab these bands and start pulling them from the loom. If made on one loom, this bracelet will need to be extended to fit your wrist comfortably. Place your loom with the red arrow pointing away from you. To extend the bracelet, you must first decide how many bands you need. For smaller wrists, you may only need 3 or 4 to extend the bracelet. For larger wrists, you may use 6 or more bands. You place these bands in a single chain, going up the side of the loom. And then once you place that last band, you'll attach the bracelet. You locate the cap band on the end of your bracelet, and you'll stretch it from the last pin to the one behind it. So you stretch that like that, and then you'll loop your bands. Once you loop the last band, you'll pull that to the center pin, and that creates an area where you can attach your C-clip. Grab your C-clip so that the open side is facing forward, secure that on the band, and then lift your extension from the loom. On the other end of your bracelet, pull the hook away, slide your two fingers in. This creates another area where you can attach the other side of your C-clip. Hold all bands to one side, and then secure those on the other side of your C-clip. And there we have the finished speckled rhombus bracelet.